manqoolat.com پڑھیے دنیا بھر کی خبریں اور معلومات دنیا کی مشہور تین زبانوں میں اردو انگلش اور جرمن میگزین کے ساتھ
Prime Minister Khan, thank you very much for joining us. Let me start by asking you your assessment of the situation in Afghanistan right now with U.S. troops almost completely out after 20 years.
Well, Judy, I think the U.S. has really messed it up in Afghanistan. You see, first of all, they tried to look for a military solution in Afghanistan when there never was one. And people like me who kept saying that there's no military solution, who know the history of Afghanistan, people like me were called anti-American. I was called Taliban Khan. For anyone who objected to this way of, I don't know what the objective was in Afghanistan, whether it was to have some nation building or democracy or liberate the women, whatever the cause was, the way they went about it was never going to be the solution. So when they finally decided that there is no military solution, unfortunately, the bargaining power of the Americans or the NATO forces had gone. When there were 150,000 NATO troops in Afghanistan, that was the time to go for a political solution. Well, once they had reduced the troops to barely 10,000, and then when they gave an exit date, the Taliban thought they had won. And so therefore it was very difficult for now to get them to compromise. It's very difficult to force them into a political solution. So because they think that, you know, they won.
Well, whatever has happened in the past, as we said, the Taliban now is on the rise in Afghanistan. Is that a good outcome for Afghanistan?
The only good outcome for Afghanistan is that if there is a political settlement which is inclusive, so they form some sort of a government that includes all sorts of different factions there, obviously Taliban part of that government. The worst situation in Afghanistan would be if there's a civil war and a protracted civil war. And from Pakistan's point of view, that is the worst case scenario, because we face two scenarios. One, refugee problem. Already Pakistan is hosting over 3 million Afghan refugees. And what we fear is that a protracted civil war would mean more refugees. And you know, our economic situation is not such that we can have another influx. Secondly, the worry is that the civil war will flow into Pakistan, because you know the Taliban are basically ethnic Pashtuns. Now there are more Pashtuns on our side of the border than in Afghanistan, and so the worry is that if this goes on, the Pashtuns on our side will be drawn into it. So that's, and that also is the last thing we want.
And I do want to ask you about Pakistan. But before we leave Afghanistan, the United States has been asking your government for many years to help in the effort to limit, to fight the Taliban in Afghanistan. But the U.S., other organizations now say they have massive amounts of evidence that Pakistan has helped the Afghan Taliban with military, with intelligence, has helped them financially. How do you explain that? This is a terrorist group operating in Afghanistan. How do you explain the support your government has given repeatedly over the years to the Afghan Taliban?
Judy, I find this extremely unfair. And so you should know a little bit of the history. Come 9/11, Pakistan had nothing to do with what happened, the terrorist act in New York. Pakistan, in the sense that Al-Qaeda was based in Afghanistan, there were no militant Taliban in Pakistan. No Pakistani was involved. And so when the Pakistani government decided to join the US's war on terror, this country took a was devastated by that. 70,000 Pakistanis died in that war, which we had nothing to do with. We had over $150 billion lost to the economy.
It's not the only thing that's blamed, but it's an important thing that's blamed, in that the Afghan Taliban has always been able to have a safe haven next door in Pakistan. And again, the U.S. says it has mountains of evidence that your ISI, other elements of the Pakistan military, have helped the Taliban in Afghanistan over the years. Just in the last few days, there's a report 10,000 Pakistan fighters have crossed over the border to help the Taliban in this most recent fighting. So this is going on right now.
Judy, for a start, this 10,000 Taliban, or they call the Afghan government, said jihadi fighters have crossed over. This is absolute nonsense. Why don't they give us evidence of this? Firstly, let me just go back. When they say that Pakistan gives safe havens, sanctuaries to Taliban, where are these safe havens? When we say there are 3 million Afghan refugees in Pakistan, who are, by the way, the same ethnic group as the Taliban, Pashtuns. Now, there are camps of 500,000 people. There are camps of 100,000 people. And Taliban are not some military outfit. They are normal civilians. And if there are some civilians in these camps, how is Pakistan supposed to hunt these people down? How can you call them sanctuaries?
Let me ask you, Mr. Prime Minister, what relationship do you want now with the United States? You've said under no circumstances would you allow the U.S. to set up the CIA to have any sort of bases in Pakistan to support counterinsurgency. But are you saying no cooperation with the U.S. To fight terrorism?
When you say about U.S. having bases for counterterrorism, please let me make you understand this. When a country loses...
हमारे प्रोग्राम सोशल मीडिया पे मनकुलात के नाम से आप देख सकते हैं. YouTube पे मनकुलात के प्रोग्राम को लाइक कीजिए और बावक्त बरखबर रहने के लिए हमारे चैनल्स को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और बेल आइकन का बटन दबाना मत भूलिए.